The gentleman is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Let me first thank the chairman of the committee for his spectacular work on this bill. Look, this bill provides much needed relief and resources to Texas, Florida, the U.S. Virgin Islands, California, and Puerto Rico. And I've heard a lot in this debate, but let's be very clear. This bill treats Florida, the folks in Florida, Texas, Puerto Rico, the U.S. Virgin Islands, and California exactly the same. Exactly the same. Significant portions, Mr. Speaker, of my district were hit hard by Hurricane Irma. Communities are still working to get back on their feet. Communities like Everglades City and Chokoloskee and Plantation Island and Immokalee and Montura Ranch. This bill helps meet our federal obligation to ensure the full appropriate federal commitment is there for long-term recovery. Mr. Speaker, for highways, this bill funds repairs for the 2017 storms and clears a backlog of prior years. In the housing side, this bill provides $26.1 billion for community development block grants. Of that, $13.6 billion is provided to meet all remaining unmet housing, business, and infrastructure needs for those hurricanes, and yes, that includes the Virgin Islands and Puerto Rico. The remaining $12.5 billion is provided for mitigation grants. Again, also to Puerto Rico and the Virgin Islands and Florida and California and Texas, all of those are treated exactly the same. So again, these grants provide resources to our communities so that they can rebuild. Additionally, I'm pleased that $3.8 billion is allocated for the Department of Agriculture. This will go a long way to help those affected, those farmers, and like the ag industry and the citrus industry in the state of Florida. So again, I strongly urge a vote yes on this important supplemental. I once again want to thank the chairman, Chairman Freelandhausen, for your leadership, for your courage, for bringing forward a good bill that helps the folks in our country and that treats everybody equally, equitably, and fairly. I yield back, Mr. Speaker.